Welcome back to another video. My name is Stephen Foster, and today I wanted to give you all my first impressions, having used the iPhone 14 Pro now for, I guess, the last few days since it came out on Friday. Got it day one, was able to do an unboxing. I figured I'd just splice some of those shots in here to show you my insights, effectively what they were, was this phone is a little bit thicker, it's a little bit bigger, as far as depth goes, than like the 13 and 12. The camera module is absolutely massive. It's like now, I think it's more than half the distance across the back of the phone. That's just wild. I'll get more into my thoughts on like Dynamic Island and all that other stuff later here, but I wanted to give sort of my experience talking about the camera system here. I think that's a big reason why people upgrade their phones in general. I think that's a big selling feature of the iPhone itself. And this year we did get a few really important updates, I think both to the main camera and to the selfie camera. So over the weekend I did a shoot for my friend Braden, who you guys have seen on this channel before. He's a professional skydiver, helicopter pilot, wingsuiter, all that crazy stuff. If you wanna learn more about that, I will link the interview I did with him down below. But I gotta do this cool shoot with him where we were photographing him jumping out of a plane over a football stadium, like a college football stadium, with an American flag, like a 10-foot American flag strapped. And it was pretty rad. I'll throw in some of those photos. I took those on, well, I guess this camera, the R5 with the 70-200. But I was taking some vlog, just video of it with this camera on the iPhone, thinking, okay, let's just see how this performs. I don't quite have the focal range on here to be shooting something like a skydiver, but I actually really was impressed with the video. My favorite shot that I was able to get on the selfie camera of all things was this shot where I'm kind of looking down at the camera and you can actually see Braden moving around in the sky, which is pretty crazy as far as like the contrast, and it was broad daylight. I think it was about 1 o'clock in the afternoon. That selfie cam actually looked pretty good for trying to grab that little object with like my face in the foreground too. I was pretty impressed by that. The front-facing camera I just threw on with the built-in camera app. I'm gonna do a whole other separate review or like side-by-side comparison of like ProRes on this camera compared to like C-Log 3 on the R5. I'm actually just waiting on like a bracket to connect this and mount this near the R5 so I can sort of do like a side-by-side for you guys, but sort of out in the field and shooting standard 4K with the color profile that's on here. I was actually really impressed. I could see myself using this phone for more vlogging type things, where in the past, I always felt like it was a trade-off. Like, oh, I really want the quality of the R5, but the ease of a phone is so much better. This, I think, is a step in the right direction, a big step in the right direction to having a really quality vlog that's a lot closer now to using something like a big mirrorless camera. And then earlier today, I'm filming this on Monday, September 19th. I did a shoot with my buddy Sam. You guys all know Sam if you've been watching this channel for any amount of time. We got out, we're shooting some fashion stuff, or I guess clothes, you know, outdoorsy type things. And I just wanted to kind of see what photos I could take with this phone. Nothing super scientific, but sort of using the like raw feature of this camera and just seeing what the main camera can do out in broad daylight. I do need to do a proper low light test on it, though I think that will be its own video, and I'll try to dive into like noise and also using third party apps, which is a whole nother thing that I'll get to in a second here, because third-party apps are not quite ready for the iPhone 14. Probably in a few more weeks, hopefully, it'll be not as big of an issue, but you're gonna be using the built-in camera for right now, at least. The main takeaway, though, from this camera as a photography camera, I think, is two things for me. The first is this 24 millimeter focal length on the standard camera looks really good. Like I always felt like that range in between 24 and 28 felt so much like the phone focal length, because almost every phone's main camera shoots that. 24 though is like a very standard, I mean, I'm shooting this video on 24. I've been shooting most of my videos at 24 on this channel for almost 2 years now. Having like a normal focal length in the standard camera is just something that adds some personality to this camera that puts it in another league, I think. And I've been quite surprised with that, the character that you get from that. The other thing is color. I think that's, having not been able to fully test this in low light yet, the color, at least in broad daylight, that you get out of this like raw image that comes off of the phone, which is very meaty. I mean, some of these raw images are larger than the RAWs that come out of my R5. That's not to say they're the same quality, but I have been finding that even with the 10-bit RAW image here, I feel like I get a little bit more color out of it than say the 13 or the 12. And that's a nice upgrade. It feels like it's, again, getting closer to, like, I can grade some of these images to look a lot closer to my EOS R5 and maybe even replace my R5 in some situations when I'm shooting for different clients and brands. Some final things to note, I wanted to just make this video real quick. Like I said, I'll break down, I think, some of the really important things like low light photography along with the like ProRes RAW video stuff. I think those videos are gonna be their own separate things because I wanna do a deep dive into each of those. So subscribe to this channel if you are not, and that'll show up in your feed at some time in the near future. But there's a few things getting in the way of being able to pull that off as far as the software goes. A lot of third-party apps are not yet updated for this phone. I unboxed this phone on Friday, the day that these kind of became available for us normal people that aren't like MKBHD and Peter McKinnon, Tyler Stallman. Love Tyler Stallman. But yeah, even just using this over the weekend, I have yet to see like updates from like Filmic's First Light app. I was having some problems with Halide. I'm sure they're already cranking out a fix for that. I was able to use the Adobe Lightroom camera. That's the camera that's like built into Lightroom Mobile. And that worked okay. I feel like I was getting some shutter lag though, and I couldn't actually tell in the app. I need to go back on my computer now and actually see, were those actually being taken at the 48 full megapixels, or were they just being snapped off as 12 megapixel RAWs? And switching between the lenses was very slow. I think there's probably like an API update that they may need to do to speed that up, is just my guess. But I feel like over the next few weeks, as these different app makers start sort of refining their apps for the iPhone 14 Pro and the Pro Max, it'll be, I think, a lot easier to do some of these tests with like low light stuff and really pushing the sensor and getting the raw information off of that sensor in a third-party app. Like I said, like with the Moment app, Halide, First Light, because the built-in camera app is kind of still for not pros, right? Like, I hate that like switching between the macro mode and like the standard lens. I know you can turn it off, but that's not that's not a pro feature. And the fact that that's on by default is, at least on the pro phones, I think is a whiff. Aside from the cameras on this phone, which this phone is definitely the best cameras in an iPhone, any mobile phone that I've used, by far. It is a noticeable leap, even over, I think, the 13, definitely the 12 and previous phones. I guess speaking to a few of the other features on this phone that I talked about earlier in this video, the display, the always-on display, is really nice. I have found myself using that a lot, and I don't feel like it gives me that big of a hit to my battery life. I still get an all-day usage out of this phone, even on Saturday when I was out shooting Braden doing a skydiving thing, that wasn't an issue. I was, you know, I think I took probably 10, 20 minutes worth of video, and yeah, didn't feel any impact to my battery life, at least on the day. The dynamic island to me just kind of feels like, it's fun, you know, I enjoy it. It's well executed. It's not the most important thing to me. I just think it'll be cool once like all that stuff is hidden behind the display and it's all just display, but it's nice for now. It's like pleasant, but that alone is not worth the upgrade. I do think the cameras, if you are doing professional stuff, and I'm looking forward to seeing what I can do here in the studio recording YouTube videos with something like an iPhone 14 Pro, I think that'll be really interesting, especially seeing like a side-by-side between the C-Log 3 stuff. But yeah, until then, I think it's really early. I know a lot of people are already posting reviews and stuff, but I am curious, what are you most interested in learning more about with the iPhone 14 Pro and specifically its camera system? Are you interested in video and seeing like what color performance and some of the other things that I guess are available on this new sensor? Are you interested in photography and like some of the more like low light performance that you can get out of like a 48 megapixel sensor? I'll be testing all of that stuff here on this channel very soon, but I figured I'd throw it out there. Is there another feature from the camera side of things that you wanna see? Probably do some more vlogs. I'm very impressed with this, like both the selfie camera and the main camera have got me like stoked on doing vlogging again. But yeah, leave a comment down below with any particular topic or point questions that you may have. and I'll try to answer them in a future video. With that, I just want to say thank you to everyone who has subscribed to this channel. I am just so honored and thankful for all of you. Please be kind, both in life and in the comments below, and like this video to send good vibes across the internet. And we'll do it again soon. Later.